Hello everyone, this is Ekta Takrani. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in this video, we will continue with class 9, Economics chapter 3. Yes, you remember poverty as a challenge. We are working with this chapter and we have so far what we have discussed. Let us recall. We talked about poverty, poverty line, vulnerability. Then we talked about social exclusion and interstate disparities in poverty, global poverty scenario. So these were the topics we talked in the previous videos, right? So what we were doing till now is we were talking about the problem. Yes, poverty is a challenge, right? What we were doing till now, we were only talking about the problems. So we have to think about the solution. When we are saying that poverty is a multidimensional problem, it is a challenge for the country's growth. So we have to work on the solution. But before coming to the solution, we have to find out the causes. Yes, right? So in this video, we are going to talk about the causes of poverty. Very important topic. What are the causes that still we are struggling with this? Still we are having, from decades we are struggling with the issue of poverty. Why we are not able to come out of this? That is, there are some reasons that we have to find out. So let us see here the first one. Okay, for this you have to go back to the time when the Britishers were ruling over us. Low level of economic growth during British rule. What was happening? When the Britishers were there, they were not promoting the Indian industries. In fact, they were suppressing the Indian industries. They were not allowing them to flourish. So that time they were struggling for their livelihood, and since that time, before independence, still the people who struggled that time, who faced problems of economic crisis, still we are facing this problem. So what we can say, that time there was a poor economic growth of the Indian industries. Okay, Britishers were promoting their products, so the Indian industries were what they were experiencing, poor economic growth. There was a very poor economic growth. Now another problem, what it will do, it will add fuel in the first problem. What is happening? Low level of economic growth. Economic growth is very low. And what next is happening? High growth rate of population. Already we are having poor economic growth. We are not able to grow economically. And on the other hand, population is increasing with a very high pace, very high speed. Population is going high. Now what will happen? It is adding another problem. More population, low economic growth, and it increases the poverty in our country. Okay, this problem, again it will invite another problem. Lack of job opportunities. When there are more people, high population, poor economic growth, high population, what will happen? People will not get enough job opportunities. Okay, but here in this point, you have to add more. That is what, especially in agriculture, because our country is agrarian economy, where more than half people are engaged in agriculture. Directly or indirectly, people depend on agriculture. So when the Green Revolution came, there were certain developments in agriculture, but still it is not enough for the people to support a big number of population. Job opportunities were there, but it is not enough to support the high population. Okay, so many people are struggling. What they are facing? Unemployment, another burning issue of our country. Unemployment. So what we can say? Lack of job opportunities. People, they are not getting enough job opportunities. So the reason is, that is the reason for poverty. Move to the next point. The fourth one, unequal distribution of wealth and land. You know, in our country, there is a big difference, gap between haves and have-nots. The rich are very rich, the poor are very poor. So what is happening? The rich people are acquiring wealth from their ancestors. The cycle is going. Grandfather is rich, he is transferring the wealth to the your father, then father will give to the son. So the cycle goes on. Rich people, they acquire wealth from their ancestors. But the poor people, they are not getting enough chances to come out of poverty. Okay, not only wealth, this point will apply to land also. because in our country most of the land is owned by the rich people. We call them landowners. From generations they are landowners. They are rich people with a lot of land. So poor people, whom we call landless people in villages, they struggle a lot. They have to work as a labor. So another reason is lack of land, unequal distribution of land and wealth. Then comes the last point, more we will add, no problem. Here we will see very important, why it is important, because we can say this is unique for our country. This happens especially in our country, social factors. When we live in society, to fulfill the social obligations, social duties, I take it as my duty that I have to pay this sum of money to my daughter on her wedding, dowry. People, if they are even not able to pay, what they do, they just seek loan. They take loan and they pay for dowry. We have to say they pay for dowry. Then even for the funerals or certain all such ceremonies, they take loan and they distribute food or whatever they do. These are the ceremonies happening in our country. So what it is doing in our country, people spend lot of money. They take loan, okay, and to pay back this loan, another loan they take. So what they are going with, they are trapped in this debtness. We can say, we call it debt trap. They are trapped in the debt. They continuously take loan after one after the other. So these social reasons are another big cause of poverty in our country. Because to fulfill the duties in society, people take loan and anyhow they fulfill these duties. This is the reason of poverty in many societies. So this is what we have discussed, the different cause of poverty. Okay, what we have seen, different 5 points. More you can add, illiteracy, another burning issue. Okay, because they are not having enough education, they are not getting job opportunities. Okay, so this is another problem people face. So we can add more. This is what you have to prepare and you have to get the confirmation of your 5 marks answer. It's a very important topic, that is cause of poverty. In the next video, we will work on the solutions, not only problems. Now we have to come to the solutions. What government is doing to eradicate this problem of poverty? Still, we are saying it's a problem, it's a challenge. What government has done, we will talk about different programs initiated by the government to remove this problem. Till then, you prepare this and I told you, get the confirmation of 5 marks question and study well. Goodbye.